Grade 11 IT Theory Module 3.2, IT and the Workplace. When we think about computerizing a business, we might think, why? Why would you want to do this? Well, usually to save money and to save time. But you have to think, computerizing a business is going to cost money. Is it worth it? And what does it entail? It's not just buying computers. Got to think of all the rest of the things that are going to be need to be done. So what are the implications of computerizing? We'll look at different aspects and the advantages and disadvantages. So in the specification and development, when you want to buy a new computer system, you can design exactly what you want for your problem, which is a huge advantage. The disadvantage is that if you have a very specific problem that nobody else has thought of solving, it could cost a lot of money and time if it needs to be developed, especially for your needs. With regards to staff, the advantage is generally more computers will be operated by clever, skilled people, will mean you need less employees. But on the other side, you also need higher skill levels, you'll have to train the people and usually pay them higher salaries because of their higher skills. Capital costs, initially you'll have to put out a huge investment to buy hardware and software and to pay for the development of whatever system you need. But in the long run, the costs, the running costs will be lower, and eventually you will make a higher profit. Also, with efficiency, computers lead to greater efficiency and greater productivity and profit. But on the other side, with regards to efficiency, you need to pay people to be trained, and you need to constantly upgrade your hardware and software, so those are also other factors to consider. With regards to information, a computerized system usually produces better information, more precise, more reliable, and it will help your business be more effective, competitive, and productive. But remember that information is only as effective as the data you input. Garbage in, garbage out. And the reports you've generated. So you have to manage the input and the processing. You can't just simply say, it's a computer, it must do the work. So let's talk about what IT brings to the workplace. Better record keeping or data storage, management, retrieval, and analysis. Computers are more precise generally than people once they've been correctly programmed, then they are generally more reliable and more effective. They allow also better communication and a visual presence. Computers allow you all sorts of communication with emailing and Skyping and many other possibilities. And remember that also with emailing, you are always available. Emails may arrive in the middle of the night and people know they will be replied to by the next day. Automation helps in digital process management. The data is automatically gathered, stored, and processed. And in office automation, you can put in place things that happen automatically. For example, billing your customers at the end of the month or checking that you've received the money from them. These are all things that should be happening automatically. The computer will take care of them. And the staff only needs to check it, that it's all running smoothly. Robotics, these are things that help machine perform tasks that are controlled by computer. And sensor-driven computing. So here we have sensors of all sorts, gathering the data, and it could be temperature, it could be access control for your staff arriving and leaving work. All sorts of data can be gathered by sensors. And then the computers will process the data and you will get information that can be used in the business. artificial intelligence is another way that you can use computers, and here, program the computers to take decisions according to certain sets of rules. As IT changed the workplace, we're going to look at a lot of different careers and see how IT has changed the workplace. Here in the picture, you see an old photo of many, many workers assembling cars, it looks like, on an assembly line. But these days we have, with IT, we have sensors, robots, and very sophisticated software that can assemble cars nearly all by themselves. So a lot of manufacturing has been automated, and this means that less people are employed. But on the other hand, the work environment is safer because machines can work in places where it's dangerous for humans to work. There's greater precision because machines don't get tired. There's greater efficiency because machines don't go on strike and they keep working tirelessly. And the productivity goes up. This is a picture of an assembly line totally worked by robots. With jewelers, they have computer-controlled, very precise tools like laser cutters and 3D printers that allow them to make more beautiful, more precise jewelry that they were not able to do in the past. It will take less time to produce an item as well. For surgeons, these days they can do less invasive surgery. Small robotic arms will go in to tiny holes. Have you heard of keyhole surgery? And they do the work inside the body where the doctor only needs to control the arm. It reduces danger for patients. There's a quicker recovery time because the incisions made are not as big. There are laser scalpels that are far more precise. You get computer-based imaging like CAT scans and PET scans, and you don't have to open the body to see what's going on inside. There's a lot of remote-controlled equipment used inside the body. Musicians, the computers have allowed huge advances for them. They can record albums on a tablet in the garage. It's much easier to work. The costs are much lower. They can also distribute their work directly through the internet, and they do not need a studio with all the fancy equipment. For film and TV program makers, TV production can be done using digital cameras, and they can be edited on high-end desktop computers. For film, things have been slower to change to digital because movies are played on huge screens in movie theaters, and therefore the resolution is much higher that is required, and it's not as easy to go and edit it on a little computer. The workplace and work process moved from working with film, chemicals and physical, scissors and tape, editing tools, to a stream of computer data that can be captured and edited with ease. For engineers, the ability to quickly and efficiently design, model, test, and prototype has come about with computers. It means that you can get a new product to the market much quicker because the time that is required to develop it is much faster, and the design cycles are quicker because of the computer. And you have a better quality finished product. For artists, illustrators, and photographers, there's additional media options. They can create art using computers, and they can put their work out there on the internet, which makes it easier for them to advertise. They can also do image editing and retouching. They can do artwork for film and TV, 3D modeling and graphics, and these are new careers and new marketing opportunities for artists. Writers and journalists, They don't have to always work in the office. They don't need to scribble little notes on paper. They can record everything. There's powerful writing software available for them and many tools for research and communication. Data analysts, there are many tools that make their work easier. They have to collect, manipulate, manage and process data. Remember, they collect the data in a company and decide what program, what computer systems the company needs. They can also use the new types of calculations and pattern matching. Accountants usually keep track of money and they do budgets and plan expenditure, and they can use computerized tools to do this. Also, they can use what-if situations which the computer can generate for them. For managers and business executives, managing staff, finances, and resources effectively depends on access to information. And with good ICT systems, they have a lot of information which is available, and therefore they can manage better. Teachers. Multimedia teaching aids have made their job more interesting and allowed them to keep the learner's interest better. They can use technology to streamline and speed up their administrative duties. And, okay. Now, we're going to talk about a few concepts to do with working from anywhere. So, one aspect of that is that there's a global village and that people do not need to only work in the country that they live in. Also, employers can go and look for people to work for them that come from other countries far more easily because of the shrinking globe. A few concepts we will look at in the next few slides. And outsourcing is when you get another specialist business to run part of your business that is important for good functioning, but which is not part of your own speciality. Telecommuting is when you work from home using technology instead of traveling to the office. And it's been made possible by many innovations with communication, mainly on the computer. One of the problems with telecommuting is that you're not interacting and in the office with all your other colleagues, and you can get very isolated, and it's not always as easy to pick up the phone as just walking into somebody's office and talking to them when you need something. The advantages which even municipalities and governments look at and try and increase telecommuting because of is that there's less traffic and less congestion. And also people like it because they waste less time traveling. The home office is just when you use part of your home as an office. It's used by freelancers, therapists, and all sorts of small businesses. The mobile office is when you can set up an office anywhere because you've got the communication tools in your pocket or in your laptop, and you can work on a mobile computer. A virtual office is a special kind of office which functions for many different businesses. So if you're a small business and your home office is not good enough to maybe meet with clients or have a physical delivery address, you might rent a virtual office. A virtual office is a real office, but it's not yours only. You are sharing the facilities. So you pay rent, and then you will have a shared secretary, meeting room, delivery address, reception desk. And the advantage is that it's much cheaper than having to run your own office. You might not spend a lot of time there, but you will call it your office. A few IT careers we need to look at. A PC technician is a person who assembles, upgrades, and repairs computer hardware. A programmer writes code or writes software. A network administrator manages a network. A graphic designer designs the appearance of things. He designs a lot of pictures or graphics on his computer. The web author is a person who uses multiple tools to plan, structure, and create a website. A security consultant is someone who tests and analyzes the security requirements or the existing security for a business and then designs and recommends a security solution for them. A systems analyst is someone who interacts with users in a company. Usually he determines their needs and then writes a specification that the programmers can follow so that they can create the software to fulfill the user's requirements.